Do we just work on this checkpoint? Is that a reasonable thing to do right now? Man. Alright, I'm my character's shaking. No, I'm shaking at this point.
Avenger plotting new course.
Man. Alright.
These findings will likely prove crucial to our ongoing efforts, Commander. Despite a thorough analysis, I have yet to discover what, if any, advantage the Advent hybrid soldiers' enormous eyes provide. Testing their visual acuity will no doubt prove difficult.
Because they're dead. The most public face of Advent security, the standard Advent trooper serves in a first response role in areas of high public exposure. Although rumors as to their origins have persisted for years, it's only recently that we've confirmed that they're in fact a product of human-alien hybrid development. My initial autopsy indicates that the troopers were at one time entirely human, implying that some means of gradual genetic enhancement without the rejection concerns that would normally plague these experiments. The body itself maintains the general outward appearance of a typical human, with the most crucial changes occurring in the cranial structure. It is my belief that the Advent troopers receive their orders, that is to say, they are controlled directly through psionic link engineered as part of the genetic modification process. As the first discovered of the field, the eyes are notably larger, perhaps as an unintended side effect, as they seem to provide only limited improvements to the trooper's visual acuity. The Rangers have managed to disguise the glaring physical trait from the general public through the use of cleverly designed armor, Artegan. Alright. We had rough times there. Huh. Battle scanner. The battle scanner provides extra vision on the battlefield. Soldiers deploy it like a grenade, throwing it into hidden areas of the map that they want to reveal. Any hidden or disguised enemies will be revealed as well. That's exactly what I need. Let's make 17 of those. Let me guess, they cost money for every single one though, right? I assume. Ah. Data decryption. This will give me, like, what, intel bonus? Psionics. Oh, you need delirium crystals for those. I can deduce my team's resources, yeah, a large amount of intel stored within. Next level of weapons is handy. Let's do the autopsy.
I am at a loss for words to describe the difficulties we have had in attempting to handle this creature, affectionately known as the Faceless, to our troops. The nebulous form of its physical structure, including a pliable, semi-solid outer layer, seems to be slowly degrading now that the creature has expired. There is also a pungent odor that only seems to grow stronger as time passes. Although I had realistic expectations as to the limited resources and facilities available to me on board the Avenger, I have to say, it's taken some getting used to. Even with the ship's dampening field, frequent turbulence and the occasional evasive maneuver make it difficult to conduct experiments of any notable sensitivity. I may have to adapt my research techniques to maintain efficiency under these conditions.
Hey, Commander.
So battle scanners and flashbangs both seem really useful for disorienting enemies and for being able to see stuff before I run into it, because it ruins everybody. The problem is, goddamn, they do cost 30 each. Like, three of these grenades is enough to build most of the facilities we make in this game. The economy in this game is interesting. I definitely could use the next phase of my income to happen, among other things. Goddamn, I think I want a battle scanner, though. There we go.
Tigan seems to have a habit of scratching that scar on the back of his head. I wonder if anyone made sure his chip was actually removed.
Is there somebody left to try to clear supplies?
I'm going to need more help on the engineering team before I can start clearing out some of these other rooms. We should recruit an engineer.
Okay, the only one's busy, so that none of that. And I don't have the money to recruit an engineer right now. Let's see. Oh, that's interesting. Chat says that if I build an item, I always have one of that item forever. That's interesting. I did not know that. I thought I had to build one every time. I assume that means that I have to build a new one every time I want another one, then. Okay. So then I can have a flashbang and a battle scanner and a med kit on my team every round. That'd be really handy. because I think I need the ability to throw a line of sight grenade behind a building like that, because the these missions we're doing are like, hey, get to this location in like 8 turns or you lose, and like even when I'm practically running there full speed, I can barely make it there in time sometimes. So being able to throw a grenade over a wall to see what's behind it would very much help, because I need to know what I'm going into, because scouting by line of sight is obviously very dangerous. I was surprised that they saw me though still, because I did peek around the corner, so I thought that would give me line of sight, but not reveal them to me. Oh well. Let's see. Overgrown check. Yeah, let's finish this checkpoint, damn it.
Commander, we have a priority message coming through. It looks like an encoded signal from the resistance. Patching it through to your quarters now.
I'm never going to finish looking at this one location. They're never going to let me do it.
Hello, Commander. It would seem your recent activities have gotten Advent's attention. Our unwelcome guests are on the move. Advent has been diverting considerable resources and personnel to covert facilities across the globe. The exact details of these operations are highly classified. However, they do have one thing in common. A single word that appears in all their files. Avatar. I believe the black site we had previously uncovered to be but a part of this Avatar project. Based on what we have uncovered so far, its true scope is far greater. This project is being directed from the very top of Advent, from a source I am still unable to determine. All attempts to uncover its identity have met with failure. It is time to take a more direct approach. Though we may not know the exact nature of this Avatar project, we can still disrupt it. We must root out these hidden facilities with the help of local resistance cells, disrupt our enemy's operations, and in the process, uncover the truth. Locate the source of this Avatar project, and then destroy it. Were the enemy to succeed in their efforts, I am certain it would mean the end for us all. I am confident you will take whatever measures necessary to eliminate this threat, Commander.
We're tracking the aliens' progress on this Avatar project here. If they finish what they've started, it sounds like it'll be the end for all of us.
Avatar project? Current progress. The completion of the Avatar project is the aliens' ultimate goal, Commander. We must stop the project before it's too late. Location unknown. We need to complete our primary objectives to locate the source of the Avatar project. So that's our major story mission. Whoa. It's 3 tiles along. So because I failed at the dark event, it filled up? Is that why? Huh. Do I just continue with what I was doing at this point? I mean, we can't just go flying over to it. It's just a vague location. What's Oceana do? Supplies from resistance drops increased by 20%. I haven't actually seen what these other continents do, really. Wander apparently started here in Africa. So your starting location is actually randomized. Here we go. Yeah, chat, the volume's kind of low on the stream just because whenever I increase it, people say they can't hear me over it. So, if you want a properly audio-edited version, you watch the final version on YouTube. Otherwise,
I do not think I could have predicted this outcome, though it is intriguing. I've often wondered how the aliens could conceive of such a being. Is there another world out there, filled with these shape-shifting creatures? Or are they merely another construct of alien genetic tampering?
Early reports from the Resistance referencing an alien creature said to be capable of shape-shifting were initially dismissed by local cell leaders who attributed the sightings to combat stress and malnutrition. It wasn't until our forces engaged with the creature that we successfully confirmed its existence. Surprisingly enough, the description of the creature from those early reports was quite accurate. With a varying height up to 3 meters, the specimen, currently referred to as the Faceless, has one of the most unusual internal structures I've ever encountered. Where one might expect to find a skeletal foundation, we instead see a series of malleable chitin-like structures providing various points for expansion or of several equally unusual fluid membranes. The membranes in question are responsible for the Faceless's extraordinary armor ability to mirror the form of a human, and recirculating key cellular combinations via an elaborate internal structure, the Faceless is capable of forming solid shapes while also mirroring colors and textures without physical sampling. As of yet, we've only seen evidence of the Faceless attempting to imitate humans, but not other species or inanimate objects. Whether or not that is a limitation of their genetic makeup or an intentional manipulation of their abilities by the aliens, we cannot say at this time. Artigan. This thing is just a nightmare. He looks like you can pick him up. Like you can grab the... Like his face is a hoop and you can grab it like a purse. Don't want to touch it though. Mimic Beacon. Generates a holographic decoy to draw enemy attacks for one turn. Deploy like a grenade. Thrown to a site where the decoy will appear. That sounds incredibly useful, by the way. Need cash or magnetic weapons? I think I need... I want to upgrade my weapons, honestly. 14 versus 7, though. I think I'm going to go for the weapons. Wait, is the cash decryption part of the current quest? Yeah, leave anyway. I'll be right back. Proving Ground, Resistance, Black Site Region, Contact with West Asia. No, it's not part...
I await your orders, Commander.
It's not part of the current quest. It just exists. Research? I want to get magnetic weapons.
I'll see that work begins immediately, Commander. I'll contact you when I have a full report available.
Anything that can make my weapons more effective would be very nice at this point. Alright. I'm still working on the comms. Don't have much to do with our current armory. That character won't be stop being shaken until we reintroduce their confidence by having them do a successful mission. Come on. 2 more days.
Strategic resource located.
63 supplies. Beneath a looming statue of an elder, we noticed an overgrown security checkpoint placed at the intersection of 2 roads. After further inspection, the corpse of an Advent security soldier was discovered slumped over a small desk inside. The engineer swept the site and recovered a number of useful system components. Alright. 63 supplies. That's a bit less useful than I thought it might be for how long it took, honestly. Let's see. We could build towers with our money, or we could make contact with East Asia. Let's just keep building up our basic money. Here we go, 3 to 5 days.
Commander, we've utilized all of our available communications capacity. We can't establish any new contacts until we upgrade our systems.
We can't establish any more contacts? Where's the meter that tells me that? Intel, alloys... What requirement are we currently missing?
We just got word that the Resistance hit an Advent supply line. We have an opportunity to salvage some high-value materials, assuming we can clear out the alien forces guarding the site first.
Okay. We have a mission. That interrupts the thought process for a moment. Raid the Advent troop transport. Advent's moving valuable alien technology across the New Arctic. If we strike quickly, we can recover alien tech for our own purposes. Alright. Let's get busy then.
Setting course for Sector 1, the Arctic.
Oh, you poor, poor, poor newcomers. I pity the fool. Alright. Battle scanner or armor? It is the closest range character, so maybe not armor. Let's see, what these guys have grenades by default? Let's have the specialist use the battle scanner. That seems reasonable. I don't have any weapons to swap out yet. Nope. Just slightly different looking armor. Pretty much. That's kind of fitting looking for that character. Good luck, everybody.
Skyranger deployed.
In position to drop.
According to chat, the West Asia is one of the three locations, and I have a maximum of three, so I don't have to worry about it for right now. I just need to worry about it when I want to make more contacts afterwards.
We picked up an alien transmission. They're trying to move an Advent troop transport the Resistance disabled during a recent skirmish. There's an opportunity here for us to pull some of their technology off the transport, but we'll need to secure the area and eliminate any remaining hostiles to make that happen.
Let's see if we can make some guys less dead this time. You know, just maybe. Alright, eliminate all enemy targets, secure supplies. If I eliminate all enemy targets, don't we just automatically get the supplies?
Menace 1-5, the Advent troop transport is nearby. Engage and eliminate all hostile forces.
I'm sure you won't all die horribly. Alright. Is the bottom corner of the map? No, it's... Oh, it's way down here. Okay. Looks like there's a prop road down here, though, so there's probably not going to be any more level down there. How far does it go this way? Can't really tell. And now I rotated the camera once, so I lost track of where I was going. Okay, so... No particular location to check first. No apparent timer. We should take time. Let's see. Going for the slow approach.
That's affirmative. Eyes on a hostile patrol.
Immediately. Alright. Well, we have no sniper on this run, so that's fun. Oh, those are the baton assholes, aren't they? Let's see. Avoid destroying critical supplies. Neutralize all enemy targets. Doesn't seem like we have a specific location we're trying to get to then. We just want to take out the enemy targets. This place might be a useful base to avoid getting flanked. Possibly. Let's come up to the wall here. That son of a bitch. What were my hit chances from here? Those are surprisingly high hit chances from this distance. With four characters, you could almost defeat them all. Especially with the ambush. I don't want them to spot me first if I can avoid it. Let's see here. Here's our little friend.
Orders confirmed, moving out.
Hop up behind this wall. Alright. Plagget. Move him all the way into the facility? Sure. So no sights. No one's being spotted inside the base yet. Oh, that... The roof is scary, of course. The roof is plenty scary. But I think I'm going to try to move my party in this general direction. Let's move you to the wall.
Confirmed. Moving out.
I'll try to sort of come back with this character, because they kind of went out on a limb that I don't want to necessarily go on. Alright, last person to have a turn. Yeah, I'll do Overwatch. So if we break stealth, he'll shoot. We'll see if they end up spotting me. They're nasty about that. Nothing yet. Alright, if I get to this building, I might be able to form some kind of firing line around here. Let's see, do we have any line of sight? We have roof access. Ooh. That'll get me spotted. Oh, that's them jump. That's because they'll jump through a window. That always makes you get revealed immediately. Let's see. I could climb to the roof, but the problem is I have no idea what's going to be up there. It could go very poorly for me. Let's take it slow, for once I have the ability to do that. Anyone new? Not yet. Yeah, for once I get to be cautious about this. So you're all the way back, let's push you forward. Let's push you all the way forward, behind cover.
Got it. Moving.
Here we go.
Roger that.
This should give us a nice line of sight inside the building, I hope. Alright, no one inside yet. Unless they're hiding around inside the certain rooms. Careful about that detection radius.
Go, go, go.
Push back. Alright, dare I see what's up here? It'd be bad. It's bad now. We'll see. We'll try next turn. When people still have actions to react to it if something goes wrong. Currently no enemies in line of sight. You know what, this could be a time for my battle scanner. I could just throw it up there and test it out. Apparently I have two. Allows better scouting and reconnaissance. When thrown, it provides vision near a landing site. Enemies won't notice the scanner. Oh wait, he defaults to having a battle scanner because he's a specialist, doesn't he? Can I not throw it up here? Where is this? So he doesn't deliver it with his drone. He specifically throws it, so he doesn't have the proper line of sight right now. All right. What if we try popping up there real quick?
Affirmative. Moving out.
Come on. Wait, I didn't throw it. Shit. What? I didn't choose a target for it. Wow. Okay, that was pretty bad on my part. I clearly misinterpreted the menu there. I did not choose where to throw it. Alright, good use of battle scanner. Ah, fuck me. Alright. Go inside the building.
I'm on the move.
This should give us an opportunity to fire on them from inside here, I hope. Can't quite move as far as I'd like to. Let's see, go over here. And the other character, we can open the door next. When the person up top has a nice view. Let's see. We should be able to make a mess of them once we get line of sight. I think I'm getting about ready to attack. We know there's one over there, but there could be more out there too. Any remaining turns? Just you? I feel like you're in a decent spot. If I move forward, I feel like we might blow something. Ah, this corner's probably okay. Maybe. Let's stay put for now. Alright, Tom. Let's see. Let's do that battle scanner now correctly. Damn. Where's it? Over here. And nothing. Alright. That didn't reveal much of anything for me. Can we peek over the edge without getting spotted?
Copy, moving on target.
There's the two bad guys. What if we see about opening this door then? Overwatch, hunker down, open closed door. Neither of them can fire weapons from here. Not in line of sight. This would be a good time to have a sniper. Definitely. Those two guys. I want to get the drop on them, and all this setup has just made it harder for me to do that, actually. Let's see if things improve over here at all. Nope, no fire weapon, huh? Okay. What can I do to make some noise? Is what kind of what I'm wondering. What kind of frag directions do we have? Nope. Cancel that. Cancel all of that. Let's see. We'll enter Overwatch. I think I'm going to make noise with my character upstairs next turn, and then as they approach, everyone will shoot them, hopefully. Or maybe they'll just stumble on me on their own. Alright, there's Tom. And they left. They just left, didn't they? They just left. They did the opposite of coming towards me. Son of a bitch. Alright, well this entire ambush opportunity is pretty much screwed. I'm trying to be careful because of what happened last round, and being careful is not really panning out either. Alright, I might just be bad at video games. There's a shocker. Alright, well, dare we move forward? Oops, it's not the camera rotation. There we go.
I'm on the move.
There they are. 61%, 59%. So from this perspective, can you target him? What if I could go right up against the corner of this building? Versus coming down there with you. Cover won't be great from there, it'll be easy to flank me. Let's see how the range does from here.
Moving on target location.
In range? Not in range, huh? But if I hit Overwatch, they're likely to come after us, right? It's kind of what I'm hoping for. I'm really hoping for them to give me the opportunity. Let's see. That character can probably do it from there.
Overwatch.
This guy might need to go behind out here in the open or something. He may not have proper line of sight back there. These rocks aren't ideal either. Let's try to get them to come to us.
I'm on it.
Hey assholes, how you guys feeling? 59 and 61, Stun Lancer, Officer. I'd really like to take the Stun Lancer down. There's some damage. That is a hell of a shotgun, by the way. Hey guys, look at us.
We're visible here.
I'm here to point at you in a menacing manner.
Oh no.
Target's still up.
Not as lucky as I hoped. No successful kill. And the third guy definitely did not trigger Overwatch. So that's not panning out the way I hoped.
There's heavy fire in this zone.
Hell of a shotgun blast, though. Oh, you son of a bitch. Oh, cool. We just dodged it. Oh, and now he ran into range. Okay, never mind. It worked out perfectly.
Hostile neutralized. Got something over here.
Nailed it. Promotion earned. An actual proper ambush, and we got a laser sight. Upgrade the crap out of my weapons. There we go. I'm just satisfied that this panned out in some fashion. What's your chance of hitting? Not the best, but why not take it from here? Pretty much everyone can shoot this guy. Not quite.
That is not good.
We'll figure it out. Someone else can shoot at him. 37. That is definitely worse. Let's see if we can do better. You can't do shit from here. 26. Alright. So we're going to want to actually flank him then instead. That's a flanking opportunity right there.
On my way.
He can still shadow the window. He just shot through it. Oh well. Wait. No, I thought I could shoot him. That rock is blank. That rock breaks line of sight? I guess it does.
Got it covered.
Well, if he can't see me, he'll have to move. So I'll just overwatch, and that'll get him. Oh man. Alright. Probably want to move in. This should be the proper direction.
Good copy. Moving on target.
If we're lucky, we can just take him out before he gets a turn. 30%. Alright. We have enough Everyone has a low chance of hitting, but all those low chances stack up to hopefully someone making the shot.
I'll get him next time.
Which is not how statistics work, by the way. I think I should just run up to him at this point, right? I could just try to sword him. Fuck it. Assault. There we go. There we go. Alright, now how many bad guys do we have to worry about? Do they know?
Target eliminated.
Are they gonna be coming? There's a lot of noise. You guys coming our way? Come and get us, assholes. We're just avoiding destroying supplies, wherever those are. Oh, is this the bottom corner of the map? Yes, it is. So anyone else that's left maybe up here? What's that weird line? Weird. Must be a misrender. Something that shines through the fog of war. I think it's okay for our tech to come down.
Heading there now.
In you go. Currently no line of sight. Alright. Pick whoever's in the back and have them move forward next each time. We're gonna have to leapfrog.
Orders confirmed. On the move.
This is the wall, right? They're probably not over here. They could be in that building, couldn't they? No, we have a pretty good line of sight. The main thing to worry about is they could be all the way down here, I guess. Possibly. Alright. Step behind this tree.
Heading out.
This is more like how I'm used to playing XCOM, honestly. The whole first game more or less rewarded you for these tactics.
Good copy, moving on target.
Just want to spot somebody. That we loaded for a second there. Oh, yep.
Without the introduction of human DNA, these creatures once operating under the guise of thin men now show their true form. A purely reptilian species.
No reason for them to hide. The aliens don't need an infiltration unit anymore.
That's three of them. Alright, let's see what they are. Advent Trooper, Stun Lancer again. And a Viper. Decent chance of shooting the trooper and just taking them out before they get a shot on me, but two people firing on my character's not ideal either. Well, we found where they are. Is that a building full of their supplies? This is their whole base, isn't it? This place goes on for a while. Okay. You're all set for Overwatch, aren't you guys? Yeah. Let's see if I can bait them. That'd be great. Running on back. I'll play it this way. Yay! Yay! Numbers happened. No! Numbers happened. That's a bad number. Shit. That's most of his number. Stop it.
I'm taking fire.
Man, whenever they go down to the top deck, whenever they zoom in, I have zero faith in the things that we're calling cover here. Yes. Oh, no. All right, Stone Lancer's not down, but he's close.
I'll get him next time.
That worked fairly well, except for the part one of my characters is almost dead, but when it's my turn, we might be able to fix this. 49, 48. Not the best, but honestly, this, especially this point in the game, I don't think you really get good numbers most of the time. 50. They can't even target the snake from here. 51. 41. 41. So he can target everyone. 48. 46. 45. Alright. What interests me is these guys are low on hit points. Can I get them in one grenade? Not from this range. Let's see. I'm trying to judge the radius of this thing. What is it? Looks like it's always a 3x3 square. Are these guys within 3 squares of each other? Unfortunately, no, I don't think they are. So I don't think I can exactly stack up these attacks. Let's see. Oops. One stage too far back. You also have a grenade, though. We could have some fun with multiple grenades. How about you? You're closer. Can you reach the back guy? They are finicky with this little display, aren't they? You can reach all the way back there. Alright. May just need to open fire on some of these guys. Let's try to finish off the Stun Lancer, first of all. Come on. Stun Lancer down.
Good riddance.
That's good.
Draining ammo fast.
Promotion earned. Alright. You're the one that has the other grenade. If I were to move forward, I could hit the guy with the grenade and take him out. So what I'm wondering is, can Darren slice this guy back here and get a kill? Oh, it's such a risk because I don't know what's behind there, of course. But the alternative is that he just snipes us again, which could also be very bad for us. I think I'm gonna go for the grenade and the slice. Come on. He's down. Did we spot someone new?
Nailed him.
No one new? That's a good sign. Okay. Grenade guy, you have a job to do now. We're gonna get up behind these... Oh, that's too far. Careful. We should have a line of sight from over here.
Headed there now.
There's your green. I mean blue. Don't miss. Please don't miss. There we go. I like the grenade kills because they seem to sort of skip the whole dice roll element when you just really want to make sure that guy dies this turn before he returns fire. So I think we're in the clear now. Alright. Because fuck snakes, you know? Let's make our approach. There's gotta be an enemy left somewhere, right? Alright, they just had their turn somewhere. But I don't see where it is yet. They could be inside this base. That's the whole point of what they're defending, right? Oh, this base looks like it goes on for a while, too. Alright. Is there an obvious entrance? Is that an entrance I can use? I could probably hack my way in. We'll go back to being careful again. Here, you can meet him up by this corner.
Running.
There we go. Tom. Wait, that's not where I clicked, is it? I thought I clicked in this corner. How'd you end up over there? Fuck me. Well, that happened. He's just standing in the open now. That's not where I told him. I told him to go right here. That's frustrating.
Got it covered.
All right. No one sees us yet. That's some hope that I can get through this without being in some serious trouble.
10-4.
Try to find proper cover before another fight happens. Does that guy have a health bar right now? Oh, that's a sword. Okay. That's a stun weapon. I'm like, why does he have a weird little divot there? Alright. We have to be careful because no one in this party currently has access to... No one in this party currently has a,
closing on target med kit. Now.
It's just overwatch in case someone approaches. Give us a couple people to cover this. Wait, that was the alien turn just now, right? Everyone has their actions again? Yeah. So there's no entrance here. Do I have to go over there? It looks like there's no wall over there. So that must be the way I get in. Everything else is covered in barriers. I assume I can hop through them, but that it would notify my location or something, right? That seems to be the point of those, I hope. I think. Maybe.
I'm on the move.
Alright, let's move forward. See if we spot someone. Not yet.
I'm all over it.
Let's get up on the corner. Well, now we can see into the base for a while. Still no spotted targets.
Good to go.
Dare I push that far forward? Let's just stop at the rock. Stay together. Before I get in some trouble here.
Moving to position.
Whoa, what the... Something explode? The entire, like, tree canopy just fell down on us. Are we being attacked from above? Is that what's gonna happen? That was a strange moment for me. Alright, well. There's enemies somewhere, damn it. And I'm gonna find them.
Okay.
Anyone around? God damn it, there's bad guys somewhere. Press forward. We are not spotting anyone.
Good copy. Moving on target. Advent troops spotted.
There we go. Three of them. Are they gonna scatter? There they go. Little weird how detection is totally mutual in that way. Alright, so they'll see me. Shit. Not a great group of enemies to see either. Stun Lancer. Trooper and a Viper. Alright. Do I have one grenade left? I do have one grenade left. Can I get them in one radius? None of these camera angles feel right for me. Oh, agony. Which one do I prioritize out of these two? That'll blow up the whole wall. That'll take out their cover. Yeah.
Grenade!
Don't fuck up. I'm always worried they're gonna throw it into something on accident. There we go. So is he out of cover now? Yeah, he is. There we go.
Out of rounds.
Can you even target somebody back here? You can. That's all you got? Okay, go for it. Come on. No more stun trooper.
Enemy down.
This game's sufficiently tense, if nothing else. Can you target from all the way back here? 39 is pretty garbage. Can you move this turn? You can't. If you move, then we don't get an action. So I should probably just go for it, even though it's kind of garbage. Nope. Alright, there's still two up. Hopefully they don't take out my character that's more susceptible to damage. I think that grenade went pretty well, though. What the fuck? I'm sorry, what? Wasn't aware of that one. I'm sorry. Motherfucker. Alright. There goes our shotgun hero.
About to get burnt to a crisp!
Gotta
get out of here! I wanna go home!
Wow. This game is designed to ruin me. This game is... Wow, now she's panicking. I just lost both of my...
One five. Watch those supply crates. If you destroy them, there won't be anything left.
Okay.
Once the area is secure.
So now what? I'm completely out of... So I have no named characters in my entire crew now, huh? They're either all dead or captured. Holy shit. Holy shit. That was intense. I mean, and of course my character's going crazy, so I can't control them. Alright. Fuck. Alright, the best I can do is get as close as I can to the current enemy to get a clear shot, and then take the shot. Wow, this game is mad to me. This game is so mad at me right... Oh shit, I have an empty clip. Oh, this game is mad at me, isn't it? This game is genuinely mad at me. Wow. Alright.
I'm badly wounded here.
Yes, I see that. I can see that.
Watch the
planks. Oh, man. Wow. Wow. I was gonna call the previous episode Murphy's Law, but now it's just every episode's Murphy's Law. Please tell me we could just kill this guy. Oh man.
Missed.
Motherfucker. Yep, now you're dead too, huh?
Commander, we can't afford to take losses like this. The objective isn't worth the lives of our remaining troops. I'd recommend we abort while we still can.
Yeah, I'm thinking about that. Holy shit, and you have to reload? No, chat, I do read chat. It's just... There hasn't exactly been advice to worry about, but... Motherfucker, I am... useless at this game, apparently. Wow. Yeah, I'd have to reload to even shoot again. Holy shit, this is normal mode? I played so much further than this in the original game without having any of these problems. Is this the last enemy or not? Do I dare try to reload? Oh my god. How many failed missions can I take at this point? I feel like I have to go for the reload. Take cover and reload. Aborting at this point, aborting is just brutal. He's in Overwatch mode. Fuck this guy, come on. Please. Thank goodness. Yeah, Overwatch removed with his brain. Alright, so we have no soldiers.
All hostiles are down and the area is secure. Status confirmed. Mission
accomplished. Wow. Wow. This game is very mad at me. Okay. Yeah, chat's suggesting reloading saves. If this game, if save scumming is needed to win this game, then I'm just gonna not win the game. I don't plan on save scumming entire missions like that. That's what this game is, isn't it? Save scumming seems kind of pointless. But son of a bitch, this is going poorly for me. Wow. Okay. I am not having much confidence in my playthrough right now. Not much at all. Whew. Well, right now, people who got on my Darkest Dungeon playthrough instead of my XCOM playthrough, as far as names go, are feeling really lucky right about now.
There has to be more we can do. We can't afford too many more operations like that.
Yes, that is true. Man, I felt so good about that first run, too. That first ambush went over exactly how I wanted it to. But there was two more waves of the guys. I'm not even sure how you counteract some of the tricks these guys have. They could just grab your soldiers and pull them away? Like, what? Alright, well, we got a new sharp trooper. Sharpshooter. Whew. Reloading the beginning of the mission is the same. That is also save scumming, caveman. Like, starting the entire mission over and over again until you do it right, until you win it properly, that's save scumming. That's what that word means. Alright, we have one sharp trooper. Man. They got mean. In the previous XCOM, I believe the game starts off with a bunch of dumb, giant-headed aliens, and then sometimes there's a thin man with a kind of snipes, and that is the only, those are the two types of characters, basically, for like 10 missions or so, I think. We got a laser sight, increased crit chance by 5%, improving even further with proximity to the target, and a stock for one, ooh. Miss shots make you still do damage. Interesting.